Hey everyone, and welcome back to the channel. So, I want to get back into my YouTube game again, and I've been testing out a couple of different cameras, and I realized, you know, why don't I take everyone along for the ride? So what I want to try to do over the course of the next couple of videos is compare the difference between the iPhone, which I'm using right now, it's an iPhone 10. I just want to kind of do a comparison between a vlogging style setup with my, it's a Sony RX100V. Does not have an audio jack with it. I think that's what's kind of been limiting me is the audio quality on that. Been looking at a couple of other cameras, but until then, I just want to use what I have, and I want to do some comparisons. On this particular video, we're going to take you on a little trip to my office, if you would, with the Sony, and I want to show you how it's set up and talk about a couple of the scenarios that I'm going to put the camera through, and then I'll do the same thing with the iPhone on another video. By the way, it's raining out here. Kind of yucky. My face, look how red that is. Mike, really get to the point. Anyway, let me show you my Sony, and then we're going to hit the road.
All right, here we have it here. It's the Sony RX100V. It has a flip-up screen right here that you can use in selfie mode, which is kind of cool. Little bit dirty. So I've been using this camera for a while. It's got an app for shooting time lapses in it, which is kind of cool, which I'll show you as well. Anyway, this plate that it's on is called a platypod, I believe. Maybe I'll do a link to that below as well. Platypod. And I want to be able to put this on the counter of my vehicle, and hopefully these rubber mounts should prevent the camera rig from falling off of the dashboard or into the windshield. So anyway, I will see you in the car in like 14 seconds. Okay, so we're in the car now. So I have this thing, like I said, it's up on the dash here. It's not really, hopefully this is gonna be strong enough or heavy enough so it shan't roll off of the dashboard. Basically, I'm gonna record video that I'll probably speed up in time lapse and turn into a time lapse. And then I'll do a little bit of, turn the camera around and do a little bit of chatting in the car. So here we go. Dork alert. Forgot my shop keys. I'll be back in a second. Back, I was looking for this ball head right here, this tiny little one, my Gitsu actually, and I couldn't find it. I was ripping apart my camera room and it was on my dining room table or my kitchen table. Anyway, this is a big heavy one. It's a really nice ball head. Not quite what I need. I think this is gonna work out better. And let me put the Sony on there and continue the time lapse. All right, probably not the best weather to be testing all of this stuff out, but I can't control that. So I just want to chat a little bit for a couple of reasons. One, I want to test the audio quality of this particular camera in the car. Of course, the windshield wipers are going, it's noisy outside, it's raining, air conditioning's going. This does not have any sort of ability to ingest audio into the camera other than the built-in microphone that's on the camera. So that being said, I may tweak this a bit in Premiere.
the quality of the audio, that is. Let's just say that right now would be the normal sound of the audio as ingested in, and then right now will be an enhanced version in Premiere. I'm looking at the screen a little bit, which is probably not what you should be doing if you're vlogging. I should be looking at the road, making sure that I'm in focus. Why am I doing this? Well, there's a couple of reasons. One, I want to get back to posting videos in this channel. I have a direction that I want to take these, and it's more in creating stories and creating some sort of a cinematic flow to what I am actually presenting. And that, I may have mentioned it before here, I think I may have mentioned it on my Instagram stories, that I think some of this has been influenced from the deep rabbit hole that I went down when I was researching my Iceland trip. There was a few guys that were really doing some amazing storytelling on YouTube with their landscape photography channels, Thomas Heaton being one. I'm gonna get out and get the mail here. I'll be back in a second. All right, I are back. I need to do this for myself, so I figure I'm gonna share this. Hopefully somebody will get something out of this. So again, I'm vlogging right now on the Sony RX100 Mark V. I wish it had a built-in mic jack, and then I think my search would be over. Some of these videos that I envision are gonna require some B-roll, they're gonna require me talking to the camera, they're gonna require a vlogging camera that has some good audio, some good video. It's gonna require me to be able to do some high-speed clips to be able to slow down, to do slow-mo, and it's also gonna require me to do some time-lapse. Platypod seems to be holding up pretty good on the dashboard until it falls off. Like I said, I'm gonna take this into the shop real quick and do a little vlogging in there, see what it sounds like, see if I can fix the audio up a bit, maybe test the time-lapse feature. There's an app that I use that you can install into Sony to do time-lapses. One of the cool things about doing time-lapses with the iPhone is, especially when you're driving, first of all, it has the app built in, or there's also a really cool hyperlapse app. Hyperlapse, I believe it is. I don't know what it is. So anyway, that's it. Heading inside, I'll take you inside. Maybe on the way back, I'll hook up the iPhone and we'll test the difference between using slow-mo, regular video, and hyperlapse, and also the audio quality. And I'll just make this one big, long, boring video. All right, let's head inside. In the shop now. Shoes are a little wet. Anyway, so this is one, I tell you what, one of the reasons I wanted to vlog too is I think I have a few things to share, a few tips. I have a little studio set up in here. I do some product photography and that sort of thing. So this is one place that I may be creating some content. This is some of my detail photography here. This is some food photography that I've done. This is some photography of juices. So that's essentially what I do. I'm a lighting designer, and I own a lighting production company. And this is, again, I'm really doing this for no other reason than just to test these cameras between the iPhone and also the Sony, and then possibly my Fuji. So I'm kind of walking around back in our warehouse. You can see the loading docks, you can hear the rain coming in. This is all hardware behind me. This was just returned. Really like the quality of this camera in here. I hope the audio sounds good. If anybody like Drew is watching this, Drew Dido from Harbor Entertainment, maybe I'll put a link to his company below. That was our shop, so I know I didn't go into too much detail, but I just wanted to talk in a couple of different lighting conditions. And I have to do some paperwork now, so maybe I will next do a quick time lapse of me working in here. Not sure why, but I think I will be in my office first. This is what we'll do. We'll do this in reverse. I'm gonna do the time lapse in my office, and then I'll do a time lapse in the other office, but it's gonna be maybe with the iPhone, but I forgot the bracket. Ugh. And then we will use the iPhone on the way home. Is that what we're doing? Probably. All right. So, time to get some work done. again. So before we go next door, got the iPhone 10 out. I'm using the front-facing camera, which means I can see the screen, so I should probably not be staring at the screen. Trying not to cover the microphone. This is that area I was talking about where I have some really cool product photography style pieces of kit that I'd like to do some videos later. I'm gonna take you back into the shop and do the same thing this time. I realize I don't have a tripod to hold the iPhone, so I'm just gonna use this A-clamp. Gonna clamp it to the side of the phone and mount this thing on a table or whatever, put it on the table. So I'm gonna do the walk around. Let's take a peek outside, shall we? Check out the rain. Walking past the lighting truss, trying not to trip over myself. Walking back into the office. Ooh, got real bright there. My daughter had helped pick out the colors in this place. I think she really did a good job. So if you go into our break room here, kind of cool. And then we have a repair area, which I'll walk into real quick. Lamps, gel, gobos, that sort of thing. Okay, got to do a little bit of paperwork. I'll see you in the car, I guess. So that was anything less than exciting, or if that even makes sense. All right, time to get out of here. All right, so for the ride home now, it's a little bit darker. I'm gonna be mounting my iPhone to this thing called the Ram Grip, and it really is like a suction cup deal that you put on the windshield. If I remember to, I'll try to put a link to this as well. So let's put the camera in the clamp and let's get going. I don't know if I touched on this. One of the reasons also that I want to start, when I do these tests, not only for myself, I want to share it, but I also want to get myself into the habit of creating content, number one. But number two, I'm interested in really learning Premiere, which is part of the Adobe suite as far as for video editing. And this gives me another chance to kind of jump in there and, you know, use Premiere, so to speak. So you only get good at these apps if you use them. So anyway, so I'm about to hit the road. I don't think I need to do any more chatting here, do I? Do you guys have any more questions? Anyway, I got my work done at the shop. It's a really quick trip. I just had to do a little bit of banking for two different businesses on two different computers. And it is time to hit the road. I'm gonna go into the Hyperlapse app to do a Hyperlapse on the drive home, or at least part of the drive. And I guess that's it. And then I'll do a wrap up when I get to my apartment or my home, my condo. More on this later. Cats and dogs, I tell you, cats and dogs, it's raining like crazy. So let's switch to a little bit of slow-mo action, shall we? All right, so it's really dark now. I'm in the parking garage and I have the lights on in my car. So sorry about the lighting. So anyway, just in closing. So, it's really not about the gear. It's about telling a story. And did I tell much of a story here? Not really, not really at all. But I don't think that should limit me on what tools I'm using.
use two cameras. I use an iPhone and I use this little Sony, again, RX100 Mark V. I think it's RX, yeah. Can't see without my reading glasses. It's a good little camera. It's not cheap. Neither is the iPhone. The iPhone's $1,000. It's like $1,000. The story, priceless. Yeah, okay, whatever. So that's all I got for now, basically. So what camera are you using for vlogging? Using the M50? Using Sony? Using Panasonic? Canon? Nikon? Fuji? iPhone? What are you using? Let me know. And I guess that's it for now. So that's all I got for now. So until next time, more on all this later.